concrete resources to fulfill their wants and desires. Psychologists, anthropologists, sociologists, criminologists, biologists, neuroscientists, legal scholars.
Good morning to all the members of the panel. The agenda for today's discussion is the importance of tax in the market. I hope the discussion would be fruitful and I request all the members to maintain the decorum of the panel.
And today, here we have Ms. Tanishka Juneja, Ms. Vibhuti Gupta, Ms. Ami Patel, who are the representative members from the Indian Business People's Organization. From the finance department of the Indian government, we have Ms. Shreya Dhumar and Ms. Anushka Dhumar. Also, we have two special guests, Mr. Harshil Dhaniwal and Ms. Yashika Chaudhary, representing the very vital point of view of the common citizens of India.
We now commence the panel discussing upon the rise in the price of basic and necessity goods.
The price of necessity goods is rising day by day. Is it fair that in our country, goods like these, which are required by people at large scale, be used by the producer as their high income?
Well, you can't blame on us like this. Prices increases due to tax imposition. If you feel I'm wrong, you can confirm it right here with the government officials present there.
Well, it is important for us to impose taxes on the products.
Yes, I think we need to clear everything right now itself. We'll be briefing you about the importance of taxes.
Yes, I think that's a good idea because after this, we may get to know the reality.
Even we will like to know, where does our money go?
Do you know how the economy works?
Yes, I think we can relate how economics works, moves by connecting it with our business.
If I buy a good from some other firm, then it becomes expenditure for me and a source of income for the other firm. When I sell my good to some other firm, it becomes expenditure for them and a source of income for me.
And yes, so we can see the flow of economy going on between business people. Similarly, we can find the same with the real economy. There will be someone to spend and someone to gain and vice versa. This way, there is a circulation of income between people.
Yes, now we are clear how the economy works.
Well, here now, at this stage of discussion, we are heading to a clearer picture.
Do you know from where does the government get the income to spend and where is it being spent?
Yes, the taxes which you collect from us becomes revenue for you.
This is exactly the way economic works.
Yes, we also know that the money goes for the betterment of our country and for social work.
Apart from source of revenue, how does the tax help government to improve our society?
Your speculation is right. Taxes are imposed to discourage harmful consumption of goods. Certain goods are considered to be harmful for consumption. These goods are known as demerit goods. Let me give you an example. Cigarette is considered to be harmful, and thus government will impose tax on it so that less number of people consume cigarettes, which is considered harmful.
Yes, but I think that cigarette is a highly inelastic good in which the amount of tax imposed won't affect much of its consumption, isn't it?
Yes, exactly. And the other thing is that there will be negative externality in case of cigarettes. Well, let's take another example. So, let's consider a car. Cars add to air pollution, which is harmful for everybody. Therefore, government imposes taxes on such products which have negative externality. By imposing taxes, government is correcting these negative externality.
But we are overlooking the consequences that taxes bring with us. Since taxes imposed on the producers, we are able to produce less than what we used to produce before. Thus, resulting we profit less as we sell less.
Well, we should now hear something from Mr. Taneman.
Consumers are always affected by two ways. The product they buy, there is an increase in price and decrease in quantity. So it makes worse for the consumers. So they have to pay more prices for and the less quantity they buy.
Increase in tax results in decreased amount of production. Also, a lower amount of production means that fewer workers are needed to produce it. Thus, the tax may lead to unemployment. Society is worse off as a result of tax because there is an under-allocation of resources.
All the money that we pay is used by corrupt politicians to buy their houses and farms.
Except for discouraging the consumption of goods that are harmful to society, I think we should also look at the other benefits that taxes give to us.
Government focuses on imposing tax on luxury goods afforded by high-income earners so that after the tax, this helps narrow the difference with the income of lower-income earners. Therefore, some degree of income redistribution is achieved and also income inequality is narrowed.
But government is the only stakeholder which benefits from imposition of taxes because they get more revenues.
Why does the government need to intervene by tax? Aren't there ways to discourage the consumption of harmful goods?
Members of the panel, please calm down. This will be only fruitful if we maintain silence. Calm down.
Government does not only intervene by taxes. It also grants subsidies, which change relative prices. Subsidies are assistance to firms, consumers, or industries.
Subsidies are used to increase the revenue for producers. They also help make certain goods affordable to low-income consumers. Also, subsidies support the growth of particular industries in a market.
In 2001 and 2002, the government spent 17,494 crore as a subsidy on food grains in India. Along with that, for famine relief, 37,195 lakhs. The government is actually helping the society and working for its best. Some glitches in some officials does not predict how all the others are.
I think the government officials have justified their point.
Congratulations, we have officially completed this panel discussion on government intervention.
And also educated our viewers about the vital need to pay taxes right. The panel is now adjourned.